play, create, share. This is the mantra behind every LittleBigPlanet game. A little backstory about myself. LittleBigPlanet is the first game that I ever played with PlayStation trophies in it. The game came out in October of 2018, released by Sony's first party studio, Media Molecule, and I remember rushing over to my local EB Games to pick the game up, and then rushing home immediately to pop this in my PS3. Platformers are my jam, and one where I could beat the game and still keep playing thanks to all the user-generated community levels was a fascinating proposal. I even remember that one conference where Sony sang the praises of the PS3.
Let me know. Using and a growing consumer interest in HD has helped our industry generate more than $6.6 billion of revenue.
But when it came down to finishing the game and attempting to obtain my very first Platinum Trophy, I only collected about 30% of the trophies before putting the game down. And the distinction of my first Platinum ended up going to Burnout Paradise instead. Now certainly time has passed and a plethora of LittleBigPlanet games came out, including three mainline games, two portable ones, and a few spin-offs. Yet this game remained unfinished. That is, till now. I honestly couldn't tell you where the spark came from, but I decided to grab the Game of the Year edition of LittleBigPlanet and pick up where I left off almost 12 years ago. And with the announcement of Sackboy: A Big Adventure on the PS5 and PS4, I'm even more determined to go through the series one by one and get all the series plats. LittleBigPlanet 1 is the first step and makes platinum number 59 in my collection. So this game seems like the perfect and most fitting game to start this brand new series on the channel. As of recording this video, which is November 3rd, 2020, the platinum is still obtainable and the community, surprisingly, is still out there playing the game. I envision this new video series to help people get the platinum and to have a game plan when attempting to get it. And that's what I'm gonna do. This guide is going to exist for the people who still want to get this, despite the fact that one day the platinum will become unobtainable. But until then, let's hit the rap sheet and see what's in store for the 100% complete platinum. Media Molecule has crafted a unique, stylistic game that is both a satisfying platformer and a robust level creator. You can practically create anything your mind can think of, so long as that vision can be translated into a 2.5D plane. At this point in the game's life cycle, there are plenty of community-made levels to play, and the game's fairly good sorting system should help you find them. The pre-made levels found in the story mode are excellent as well. Each world is well-themed and the levels are filled with plenty of prize bubbles and secrets. The story is a good one too. The game has great difficulty scaling and achieving an ace for each level is extremely satisfying. I have very little bad to say about this game, other than the game needing a better multiplayer matchmaking system like its sequel eventually got. That's the only thing truly holding the game back from being absolutely perfect. But this is Platinum Hunters, the show where we look at everything it takes to get the Platinum Trophy and whether it's worth the effort to achieve it in the first place. So without further ado, let's jump right in. For some reason, LittleBigPlanet is considered a very tough Platinum to get by people in the trophy community. Heck, it's even backed up by the fact that only 0.4% of the player base of this game has it. But personally, I think people just don't have a good game plan. Aside from becoming very familiar with the game's platforming, the Platinum Trophy itself is not so bad. On the 5-point difficulty scale that I've crafted, I think it's challenging, which would be like a 5 or a 6 commonly found in trophy guides like Power Picks, PSN Trophies, or PlayStationTrophies.org. Don't worry, I'm gonna break it down for you and give you some confidence so that you can get this one. There are three main trophies that you are working towards, and along the way you'll be grabbing the rest of them. Those three trophies are Play, Create, and Share. The Play trophy involves the story portion of the game and tasks you with getting an ace on every level except the ones where you have to die to finish the level. While in the pursuit of this, you are going to have to collect all the prize bubbles hidden in each level. Guaranteed, you will be playing each level more than once while working towards this. Create requires you to publish your own community levels and have people play them, heart them, and then heart you as a creator. To get this trophy to pop, you will need 50 hearts across all your levels and 30 hearts on you as a creator. Along the way, there are a bunch of milestone-related trophies that include getting hearts, ratings, and level plays. This is definitely the more luck-based portion of the Platinum, but as I said earlier, I got you, don't worry. I have a bunch of ways to tip those odds and get it done faster. Lastly, Share is the multiplayer slash community portion of the game where you have to play 150 levels that the community has created, heart 10 of those, and rate 50 of them by dropping a community tag on a level after you've completed it. You are also going to collect a bunch of community level focused trophies and multiplayer trophies while working towards completing that said 150 levels. Did I mention that I have your back already? I did? Okay, so I'll stop saying it now. Ultimately, it's up to you on which of these three trophies you want to start working towards. I personally recommend starting with the Create trophy because it is going to take the longest to acquire. But for the sake of this video, we are going to start with the Play trophy, just to make things easier to understand for first-time players. But don't worry, I will have parts of the video marked in the description for you guys to look through, especially if you've been playing this game already and you're looking for a certain section to get a certain trophy. Step 1. Complete the story, collect all the prize bubbles, and ace all the levels. Your adventure starts out on the level First Steps, and you're going to end up working your way through all 24 levels in LittleBigPlanet. And that also doesn't include the extra levels that you will unlock by finding keys hidden in those 24 levels. If you picked up a few aces or collected 100% of the prize bubbles along the way, that's awesome. However, you won't be able to get 100% of the prize bubbles on your first try for most levels, as some require certain stickers that are collected later in the game. I suggest just clearing each level first so you can get a feel for them, as well unlock the 7 story-related world-specific trophies. On this show, I keep the names and descriptions of the story-related slash non-missable trophies hidden, but you will achieve the trophy just beginning when you clear the last level. Along the way, you're guaranteed to unlock the following trophies: Fashion Sense, for dressing up your Sackboy head to toe; Artist, for placing your very first sticker; Homemaker, for placing a sticker or decoration in your pod, which is your main hub; and both 2x multiplier and 8x multiplier just by collecting enough bubbles in a row. There is also another x-times multiplier trophy to collect, but we'll talk about that one later in the video. After you've completed the story, it's time to start collecting 100% of the prize bubbles. This is not particularly hard, but for some of these prizes, they're pretty well hidden. It's best to use a guide, which I'm going to leave down below in the description, for each level to refer to while you're collecting them. A lot of the prize bubbles are going to be unlocked by putting the right sticker in the right place. If you replay the First Steps level and place the shoe sticker in the right place, you will unlock the trophy Secret Stickerist. Eventually, while collecting prize bubbles, you will run into sections that will require you to play them with more than one player to unlock the prizes. These sections can be done by teaming up with players online or done from the comfort of your couch. Some of these sections have a 3 or 4 player sign slapped on them, but truthfully, I was able to complete all the multi-Sackboy sections with 2 players and 4 controllers at the bare minimum. Heck, if you are dexterous enough, you can even complete some of these sections by yourself, and I'm talking about the 4 player sections. However, there were some sections that even I couldn't do by myself, and I absolutely needed a partner to help out because they require far too much precision for one person to do. If you don't have any extra DualShock controllers handy or an extra person, the best thing you can do is arrange a session with players who are also trophy hunting themselves. And you can find them on forum sites like lbp.me, psnprofiles.com, or even any trophy or LBP themed subreddit. Once you have cleared all those sections and have collected all the prize bubbles, the trophy for collecting 100% of the stickers, Booty Master, is yours, along with three other prize related trophies called Forager, Sticky Fingers, and Treasure Hunter. Now, Booty Master has been reported to be bugged if you collect a story prize while your inventory for community prizes is full. I personally think this has been patched, as I was able to do this successfully with no ramifications, but better to be safe than sorry than to have to start a completely new save file from the beginning. Okay, now we can finally go after the play trophy. This is done by getting an ace on each story level and score challenge, which means that you have to complete it without dying a single time. Remember that the survival challenges don't count because they require you to die to complete them. This trophy is where the challenge ramps up, as you're going to have to learn every level inside and out and master the mechanics of the game. There are quite a few levels that you're going to breeze through once you get used to the jumping and platforming physics, but there's also a bunch of levels that are going to put you to the test and have you restart multiple times. In particular, Boomtown, Sensei's Lost Castle, the Dancer's Court, and the Collector's Lair will give you a nice challenge. By far though, the most difficult level to ace is the Bunker. You will die a lot, especially at the part of the level I like to call the Wheel of Pain. The Wheel of Pain is quite unforgiving, and making a wrong jump is going to cost you a run. I spent a significant amount of time trying to ace the Bunker, and I nearly pulled my hair out trying to do it. It's a tough level, but once you complete it and all the rest of the levels, you will be awarded the prestigious Play Trophy. Okay, wow, this is just one pillar of the Platinum Trophy, and we're just getting warmed up. Step 2, play 150 community levels while collecting all the multiplayer trophies. So 150 levels sure sounds like a lot of levels. But before you start playing random levels to grind down that massive number, I'm going to give you some tips on how you can speed up the process. Thankfully, the LittleBigPlanet community is all about sharing, and many people have levels specifically designed to help you zip through this process. The game has a search feature built in, and if you type any of the following phrases, H4H, trophies, 1 sec, share, P4P, any of those phrases, you will easily find short and or helpful levels that will help you get this done much faster. Simply play one of the short 1 sec levels and you will instantly get the Traveler Trophy. If you tag that level after you finish it, you will get the trophy Opinionated. If you leave a comment on it, you will get the Talkative Trophy. If that 1 second level has less than 10 plays on it, you will get the trophy First. Also, don't forget to leave a heart on each level you play and a heart on the author as well. Remember, you're working on the requirements for the Share Trophy. And it's just good to get into the habit of leaving hearts and community tags, which also helps other trophy hunters out there. When you have dropped hearts on 3 different authors and 5 different levels, you will receive the Networking and Neighborhood Watch trophies respectively. One of the 150 levels that you're eventually going to play should be a trip through a trophy level. The LBP community has also created levels specifically designed for the purpose of unlocking trophies, with specialized sections made for unlocking these following trophies. If you see a pit of 1,000 bubbles, that is meant to unlock the 20 times multiplayer trophy and the high score trophy for reaching 1,000,000 points. It's pretty impossible to get a 20 times multiplayer during the story levels, so this is the best way to unlock it. While playing that trophy level, you're going to come across a red button on a yellow platform. Jumping on it will send you sky high, and this will unlock the trophies Incredible Height, Incredible Speed, and Sackbird. These community-built trophy levels are extremely helpful for getting those trophies, as well as some of the DLC trophies. There are also some multiplayer-centric trophies that you're going to be hammering out. These include Friendly, for finishing a level with more than one person. Socialite, for playing a level with three people who are not on your friends list. And Party Person, for playing with three people who are on your friends list. In my experience helping other players, the Party Person trophy is often one that people struggle with for some reason. Because you need to have four people on your friends list to play, but that's not entirely true. What you can do is invite one player who is on your friends list and just have them plug in two more controllers to fill the spots. It totally works, and I've done this for many people. Here's what you're gonna do. First, party up with your friend and go into the community level search bar again and type in party person to find a short level that you guys can play on. Just make sure the person who needs the trophy is not the one with the extra controllers and has the most points when you finish the level. And voila, party person. You will also get top of the class for collecting the most points at the end of a four-player game, if you already haven't got it. Oh, and while you're at it, grab Trendsetter by placing a sticker on somebody else's sack person. You might annoy them a little bit, but hey, you're getting a trophy, so you know what? Do what you gotta do. These trophies could technically be achieved by playing a story level, but it's just much easier to coordinate it using community levels. As the community for this game has been dwindling, you still may need help setting up the right conditions for these trophies, and that's where the websites that I mentioned earlier come in handy. But back to the share trophy, once you have played your 150 levels, hearted at least 10 of them, and hearted at least 30 authors, the trophy will pop up as soon as you finish the level. With most of the in-game work done, you're now going to just have to worry about the last pillar of the game, which is definitely going to take the longest to acquire. Step 3. Publish levels and find ways to fast-track acquiring the Create Trophy. It's time to get the creative juices flowing and start working towards getting the Create Trophy. Time to make some levels and publish them out into the LittleBigPlanet world. However, before you can start making your dream level, you're going to have to dive into the level creation tutorials to get the Expert Creator Trophy. In total, there are 26 tutorials that count towards the trophy, even though there are going to be way more tutorials available to you. Just make sure you check with the guide down below in the description to make sure you're doing the right ones. Some of them are just videos, thankfully, that you just have to watch to the very end, while other ones put you in an in-game scenario where you need to complete a specified task. To access the tutorials, hop into any level over in the My Moon section, pull up the pop-up menu and click the tutorial button. This is another one of those trophies that could potentially be glitched, but might have received a patch just like Booty Master. It happens when you don't watch the videos all the way through, so again, be safe than sorry and don't skip the videos in any of the tutorials. Just watch them all the way through. After you complete the requirements for the Expert Creator Trophy, there are a few ways you can accomplish getting the rest of the trophies you need for the Platinum. You can either do it the legit way, by creating and unveiling your Picasso level to the world, and hope that enough people will get you hearts and plays. Or again, you can lean on the community and copy a bunch of levels from other creators who have enabled the copy option on their levels, and rally the trophy hunting troops to come drop hearts and plays on them. I personally chose the latter option, as I'm not that creative and don't have the patience to build a compelling level. In particular, I decided to copy a bunch of those 1 sec levels we talked about earlier. After I copied and published the first one, I fittingly got the trophy Publisher. Another level you should try and copy is any of the levels titled Creator and Team Creator, because they will allow you to grab 3 trophies pretty effortlessly. What you can do is open that level, make a small edit to it, and republish it to collect the Creator Trophy. If you do the same thing, but this time have a friend with you or a second controller, you will get Team Creator. Also, if a trophy called Dr. Frankenstein popped up, it's because the level already had a creature with at least 2 eyes, 2 legs or wheels, and a brain planted on the creature pre-built. You will have to build one yourself if you are taking the Way of the Warrior and creating your own levels, along with creating a level that has at least 30% of the thermometer filled when you're doing the creator and team creator trophies. Personally, I just think you should copy someone else's creator and team creator level. It just makes it so much easier. Alright, now you have your levels all set up. You just have to wait till you accumulate enough hearts and plays to trigger the remaining trophies. Look What I Made will pop up when your level is played by 5 people. Feel the Love will pop up when your level is hearted by 10 people. The Trophy Celebrity pops when you as an author are hearted by 5 people. And Crowd Pleaser when your level is played 50 times. Lastly, the trophy you've been working towards this whole time, the coveted Create Trophy, will appear when you have 50 hearts across all your levels and you are hearted 30 times as a creator. I suggest looking for boosting threads in forums like PSN profiles, PlayStationTrophies.org, or requesting help on Reddit in any LittleBigPlanet subreddits or trophy-related subreddits. But what you're going to need to post specifically in those subreddits and forums comes from an official LittleBigPlanet website called lbp.me. This official website allows you to share your level links and profile links outside of the game, and it's super easy to start up. All you have to do is just log into the website with your PSN credentials. Thanks to this site, it made getting the hearts for my levels and my profile so much easier. And I thank Media Molecule and Sony for setting up this site. Crowd Pleaser in particular is often seen as the roadblock trophy to getting the platinum, but you guys are gonna laugh once I give you this tip to getting it. All you have to do is create a new PSN account that has a brand new email and is not a sub account, and then play a created level on your other account 50 times. Seriously, that's it. It's honestly as easy as that. PS3 accounts don't require PS Plus to play online, so it's free. And the trophy doesn't require that you need 50 unique players to play your level. LittleBigPlanet 2 is a different story, but we'll get to that someday. But it's that simple. I've seen so many players give up at this stage of the Platinum run when it's actually so easy to get this trophy. So with all this advice, good luck with this part. And once you have all these trophies, including the Create Trophy, you will acquire the coveted 100% complete Platinum Trophy for LittleBigPlanet. I want to talk briefly about the rest of the trophies you can collect in LBP. Getting the Platinum Trophy is one thing, but I know a lot of people who specialize in getting 100% of the trophies in any given game. I salute you trophy completionists out there. But unfortunately for this game, you're going to run into a slight problem. LittleBigPlanet has 2 DLC trophy sets. The first one is the Metal Gear Solid level kit that comes in the Game of the Year edition of the game, or you can buy it standalone. This will add 11 new trophies that are actually really fun to obtain, especially the Speedy Rexecutioner for beating the Metal Gear Rex in under 2 minutes and 30 seconds. Now, the problem lies with its second DLC pack, which is the Pirates of the Caribbean level kit, has been delisted by Disney in late 2017 on the PlayStation Store. Now, in fact, all the Disney-related costumes and level kits have been delisted across all the LittleBigPlanet games. If you were smart enough to grab the DLC before December 2017, you can still get 100% of the trophies, but for the rest of us, it looks like we've gotten shipwrecked. Damn you, Disney. Always gotta ruin things, don't you? And due to this, 100% trophy completion is unobtainable for many people, especially if you're late to the party. While the Platinum Trophy has a very involved process that also puts you at the mercy of other people, I really enjoyed myself getting this Platinum. I was always intimidated by the criteria of getting all the aces and creating a good enough level, but it ended up not being so bad thanks to a bunch of tips and tricks that were discovered by clever trophy hunters. And that notion right there is what excites me most about being a Platinum Hunter and trophy hunter in general, the community aspect of all this. yeah, sure, we are working towards big numbers and 100% completion, but we are doing it together and sharing the best ways to do it. No one is competing with each other, and that's why there are a lot of guides out there and people willing to lend a hand when there's a tough time to obtain a trophy. If you like platformers, I recommend LittleBigPlanet and Going the Distance to grab this platinum. It's gonna look great in your collection. Or even if you just like to create things, this game is definitely for you. If you don't like the idea of leaving the fate of your platinum in the hands of other people, you may want to skip this one, but only if you have watched this guide and you feel like you really can't do this. And lastly, to my 100% completionists out there, this game is a hard, hard pass. Unless, of course, you have already downloaded the delisted Pirates of the Caribbean DLC and you already have it in your library.